Is whether you see fit?
No, he won't play. No, he ruptured the tendon in his hamstring, and it's a 10-week injury, so be battling to get up, I'd say.
How disappointing is that? Sheedy's obviously a big game player.
Yeah, it's very disappointing. He's, you know, arguably in the top probably five of our footy club. He's probably the smartest footballer I've coached. He sees the game really well. He's really dynamic for us. He can play through the midfield or forward, so yeah, he's going to be hard to replace.
So I know you're not going to give away trade secrets, but who's a contender to take his spot?
There's a few. Like Mitch Hardy's playing some really good footy. He's played a lot of good state league footy. Rory Lehman, who got injured in our first semi, gives us some real genuine height. You know, with Glenelg's forwards as well, so there's a couple there that we'll consider.
So Lehman's fully fit for this one?
Yeah, he'll be fit. Yeah.
So how different is this year's side to last year?
About 10 different in terms of players.
In terms of overall strength.
I think the footy club's done a really good job of, I guess, we always want to get better each year, and I think the footy club's done a really good job of recruiting what we lost. It's been pretty well publicised, and, you know, not here to make excuse or anything, but, you know, we lost 8 premiership players, so it's a really good show of strength of our footy club to be able to get back here and give ourselves a chance to compete. And although we want to keep blooding juniors, and, you know, that's our philosophy as a footy club, we understand that we want to be the best we can be every year as well, and that means blooding juniors and also getting some top end recruits in to replace what we lost, and that's how we try to stay in the fight. And I think the footy club's done a really good job to do that and give ourselves an opportunity to play Glenelg this week.
History was made on Monday night when James Chitters became the West Tigers' first career medalist. As Darren mentioned, first chance to win back-to-back flags for the Eagles. How much of an incentive is that?
Well, I guess we're here to win a premiership, and if we win a premiership, it means we go back-to-back, so they kind of coincide. So it's not our focus. Our focus is to play really well on Sunday against Glenelg, and yeah, if we do and we win, it means we go back to back. So the footy club, the boys, our whole footy department's done a tremendous job to be able to give ourselves an opportunity, and yeah, I just really want to see the boys do well. Like, just got an amazing group of players that you know, leaders with Luke, and their resilience to want to keep, you know, Luke's fifth grand final this weekend, and the careers that some of our players have had, and the ability to keep putting their hand up to play in big games is a testament to our footy club, I think.
Any retirements that you know of that from after this game, will Goldie probably go on, or is he going to think about what he might do?
Well, he works at the footy club, so if he retired, he'd probably get the sack, wouldn't he, Christine? So, Goldie will keep playing. So we're quite confident Jared Redden's going to play. Riley Knight and James Cheetus have signed on, so we'll start to try and get some momentum with that in the next couple of weeks.
And the week off, how advantageous has that been for the Eagles, rather than have to play 3 hard finals before the big one?
Yeah, I think it's good to keep playing. In saying that, I think we come off 2 really tough finals, and I think we would have probably struggled to play Friday night. We had some really sore boys, and we've taken a little bit of an individual approach this week around how we've trained. I guess we looked at, you don't really know whether you got it right until after the game, whether you win or lose, but I guess we took the individual approach that we sort of grouped them up, and, you know, some players did more than others, and that's how we approached the week. So we didn't really, I guess, you know, go full on a Saturday. We sort of, some players did, and others that needed a rest. I think this time of year it's also about mentally freshening up your players and making them feel good and making them, you know, the best they can be to play on Sunday. So that was our approach this week.
Do you model what you did 2 weeks ago against
them?
Do it again?
Can you model
that?
Well, we need to do it again, but we need to get better as well. Like, I think that day, Glenelg started really well, they finished really well. Throughout the middle of the game, I thought, you know, we had the momentum, and we can't look the same and do the same either. We need to have different matchups, and I guess, like Brett will do, keep them guessing a little bit as well. And but we feel like, you know, our best is good enough if we can get it going. But we know as a footy club it's going to be a big challenge for us. I mean, they were 17 and zip, end up losing the last minor round game. They're a pretty formidable club.
Tom, how do you feel going to your fifth grand final? How do you feel the Eagles are placed?
Yeah, mate, I think we're placed not too bad. As Sheed said, I think the the week off that we've just had. You know, whether we win or lose in grand final days, when you know you've got it right, but I think it came at a nice time with the back-to-back six-day breaks that we had in some big games. We had a big game against Sturt towards the end of the year as well. A couple of big finals games against some quality inside sort of players, very contested style of footy. So, you know, ask me after the game when we hopefully win it, and I'll let you know in a bit more detail. But, you know, I think we're as good as placed as anything.
How does this team, as she sort of touched on, you've been through five grand finals. How does this team compare to the other grand finals we've played?
Yeah, it's always hard because we've had some, you know, you look back at 2011 when we win, we have the Sigalalas and the McKenzies and all those types that are coming towards the end of their careers, but in, you know, they're great players. And then, you know, last year we have the Jordan Foots and James Rose and all these sort of types. And this year we've managed to recruit, as Sheed said, we've brought in some good quality players, which we needed to, having lost eight to 10 players last year. You know, you bring in the Menzel boys, you get a couple of recruits like a Clay Cameron and stuff like that, and it strengthens your side up again. Plus, I think, you know, personally, that we've developed our juniors really well. You know, you see the likes of Luke Beacon coming through and those types. I think that's what this club's done really well over an extended period.
Five grannies, Luke, there's a few different too. But you've gone to the first one, have you sort of learned to deal with it differently?
Yeah, I think so. I think the first one went by pretty quickly in 2011. I was at the Crows at the time and played half a year there, half with the Eagles. But the only difference is I'm probably a bit older now. I've got another 10-odd years under my belt. But, yeah, the nerves are always there. I think nerves mean that you care. So I think it's important that every player has nerves because you actually care about the game. So, yeah, I'll just take it in my stride and help out the younger boys. But, you know, it's important to get out there and remember the year that we've had and soak up the atmosphere and put your best foot forward on game day.
How have they all been handling it, knowing for over a week now you're playing the granny? You probably couldn't have left it after five, but a couple of the other boys that might not have played in many are bouncing off the wall if you had to raid in 1 year.
Yeah, for sure. The boys are pretty excited, obviously, after our win out here, you know, a couple of weeks ago. We haven't had to rein anyone in. I think it's important to enjoy the year and enjoy being in the grand final, and probably that's what the week off sort of allowed us to enjoy that for a week. As Sheed said, we've been getting our bodies right. We've had a few big games, so the boys have been just focusing on recovery. But yeah, definitely enjoying it for that first week. But, you know, once we sort of did our Saturday session, it's business as usual, and we're just recovering well and training hard. And, you know, game day will come, and what will be will be.
Losing eight premiership players from last year, proud of you of the way the group's gone about to get back to this position?
Yeah, super proud. And we've, as I said, we've recruited really well, so I think that was important. And the thing about our club is that, you know, we've been a good club over a long period of time. We probably didn't get as many results as probably what I think we should have, but we've always been around the mark, and that attracts good people to your football club, like the Menzel boys, as I mentioned before. They, you know, people want to come to your club because you're around the mark and you've got a good culture, and, you know, wins aren't everything, but they're pretty important, but the culture that we've got, I think that people come in, they meet with Sheeds, they meet with me, they meet with Patrick Gufrida and Joey Sinor, and they get a feel for what our club's about, and I think that attracts good players, and that's what we've been able to do.
Sheeds, how impressive have the Menzel boys been for the Eagles this year?
Yeah, really impressive. I think most importantly, they're good people off the field. Like, I think they've copped a bit of a hard time, and, you know, they... I think early on they wanted to change up what they were doing and wanted a new direction, and we could provide them with that. And we've been really impressed how invested they are and how good of humans they are. And I think that's the most important thing when you're trying to recruit someone to your footy club. Yeah, they've got lots of talent, and you know, you take that every day of the week, but they've really been invested the whole time through. Dan and Troy, both really smart footballers, both played AFL, bring a lot of knowledge into our side as well. And we felt like, obviously, with what we lost last year, we needed some real footy smarts out in the field and some leaders, and they both brought that to our footy club. And yeah, they've been great recruits for our footy club.
What do you mean they copped a hard time early on?
Oh, just, I guess, from, you know, I guess from the outside, it's about leaving Centrals. They're both Centrals kids, and, you know, it was a hard decision, and, you know, the fact that they might not have been loyal and all that gets banded around, but we threw our arms around them as a footy club and welcomed them into our family, and yeah, I think they've really thrived in our environment.
Tyson Stengel also appears to thrive, obviously,
in
his big game
five. Yeah, been really impressed with Tyson in his two finals. I don't think he needs much time and space to, you know, you sort of, I think playing on Tyson for 120 minutes is hard for any direct opponent. He can, pop up 5 minutes and kick three goals, as the good players do. So, once again, he's junior of our footy club. We could find a role for him and a spot in our footy club. And I think the board and everyone at our footy club's done a really good job to not only give him some direction on the field, but also off the field, which is important when you come out of an AFL environment.
Need for any changes to your team from last Friday?
We had match committee last night and had a good discussion, and final training session tomorrow night out here, so we'll finalise the team. And I've said all along that we sort of look at the teams we're playing and how we best match up against them, so we've had some good discussions and probably we'll finalise it tomorrow.
On the eve of the grand final, your first season in the SANFL, how have you found it overall?
Oh, look, I've loved my time back here. Before I left in 2007, being involved at Nord, and the league was still pretty strong. Well, it was strong then, and it's just continued to grow while I've been away. And the competition's been great. Being outside of Adelaide for 12 years, I lost touch a little bit with where it was at. And just this year to come back and see the passion from the local supporters, the community at Glenelg is just phenomenal. But what you see on game day, the way the SANFL will function this year, the media and that, it's certainly taken to a level that I wasn't aware of when I got here. So it's been a really good environment to come back to.
Did the team need one extra game in the finals? Was that a blessing in disguise?
Oh, look, we were, what I thought was 3 minutes away, but it ended up being 90 seconds away at the timekeeper. I'm not sure what happened in that last quarter, but from being going through, so, you want to make a grand final, and however you get there, you get there. And, we had to come through the prelim final, so whether an extra game helped us or not, we certainly played much better last week than we did the week before. So that gave us some things that we had to focus on from the first game against the Eagles, and again, we'll learn from last week because South pushed us all the way, and we got lots to learn from against the semi-final. So, yeah, in some aspects it did help us.
You said last week before the game, you didn't know how the boys would react after two losses in a row, because you
haven't
seen two losses in a row.
Are
you happy with how that eventuated for you?
Well, yeah, obviously. They responded really well. We had a good week, like I said to you, leading up. We were disappointed with what happened in the semi-final because we didn't play our game for the whole game. We started well and we finished well, and there was lapses in the second and third quarters which just allowed the Eagles to get momentum back and take control of the game. And we can't afford to have those lapses in big games, and against a quality outfit like the Eagles, they make you pay. So, we've been trying to look at how we can arrest that to make sure that doesn't happen within games, and that's up to the leaders on and off the field to control that and make sure they're making right decisions in those times.
When you go 7-8-9, I imagine you feel on top of the world, we can beat everyone when we play our football. Do you feel like you're in the exact same sort of mindset right now, you can beat everyone when you play your football after two losses but then come back?
I plan accordingly. That I think every team we play against, we plan to beat. So, if we can implement the game plan that we sort of want as a footy club, and the players can follow what I want them to do and put that in place, then I think we're very hard to beat. I think we've got the cattle to show that. But when you're up against quality outfits, you've got to make sure that you can have what-if scenarios as well. If they throw this at you, how do you adjust to it? And that's up to us in the box about how we adjust to things, that different scenarios that they might throw, and how you get the message across to the players. And we have conversations with the leaders during the week so that they know what to be done on the field without us always having to call it from the box. So I've got a great leadership group that can work with me on that, but I've got confidence in them and our younger group in sort of implementing that on game day.
Max, is it fitting that the two last premiers, probably the two best teams this year, are fighting out in the grand final?
Yeah, in some ways. I mean, Eagles have been a great club for a long time, and we expected them to be here at sort of this time of year, to be honest. And we didn't have a great year last year, but I think the way that we, performed this year, being sort of 7-8-1, it wouldn't have meant much if we weren't here at the last sort of opportunity. So, we've had some great battles against Eagles in the past. A couple of weeks ago was a good example of that. So I'm sure it's going to be a good game.
Do you need to do much differently this time than the last time the two sides played?
Look, you review and you, every game you play. So, we've done that. But then you got to move on in some ways and look forward to, how we can play our best footy and do what we've done for the majority of the year and just play our style of footy. So, we know that's good enough. So as long as we can bring that effort and that intensity, then we know we're going to be around the mark.
Max, how do you feel like 2 years ago when you did win the premiership? How do you feel now compared to then with your team's preparation going to the big one?
Well, personally, it's a bit different, Andrew, but, I think... you know, it's been so long since Glenelg played in grand final in 2019, but you know, we've had a lot of turnover players like the Eagles had from last year. You know, it tends to happen after a grand final win that you lose guys to the AFL or they retire. So we've got a really different sort of group at the moment. A lot of guys have joined the club and they're starving for that success and to repeat what we did in 2019. So yeah, there's no question about how much the guys want it. And it's good that we've got guys that have been there before to be able to sort of help in the lead up this week, and got good confidence in those guys.
What did you learn from the second semi loss?
How good of a side Eagles are, but also, you know, what we can do better and where our best footy is. You know, we've got great belief in the way we play, but we've just got to bring that for four quarters. You know, you can't just drop away in a second semi final at this time of year. You can't leave it until the last quarter to show up. So I think that's probably what we've taken from it.
And Brett, just on that, even when you were 17 zip, talked about the games a lot during the year, you were never completely happy with the four quarter effort. It's been a source of frustration. Now with one game to go, is it still frustrating or is it exciting knowing that maybe you can bring it on the last day?
Oh, I'd love them to bring it for four quarters this week, Andrew. There is some frustration at times, but it's also a great belief that our good is good enough. And it's having the players understand that if they continue to do what I want them to do, and like I've changed the game plan quite a fair bit from what it's done in the last couple of years, and there are still lapses in concentration when they go back to old ways, and that will still continue to evolve over the next year or so. But where we're at the moment and the style of footy we're playing is pretty much what I'm after. So very confident that again, everyone knows their role and what they've got to do. They've got to do that for the whole time.
She's touched on the Eagles' future with their player. Martin Wallop's already said he'll retire after the grand final. Anyone else that you know of that might not be here next year?
No, we haven't had those discussions yet. You know, we've certainly had a little bit of a list management chat, but you know, we're just waiting to get through this season. You know, for me, that's the next part. That's the next month. You know, there might be one or two extra, but we know this is Marlon's last game, and you know, guys will be going out there to do what they can to make sure it's a good swan song for him.